Hello and good afternoon. Welcome to the third grade Mountain Brook Super Bowl. The Super Duper, the Super Bowl. The start ends right here. Number one versus number two. The top offense versus the top defense. Speed versus tenaciousness. The Seahawks at 8-1 and the Bills at 7-2. Face off today. It is our great pleasure today to witness this great game, a game for the ages between these two incredible teams. I'm Josh Wright, and I'm joined today by the man, the myth, the legend, and our commissioner, Josh Mandel, who will be with us momentarily. We're going to start this game off and turn it over to Jay Spencer as our PA announcer to announce the players before we get started with this great matchup between the two great teams, the Bills and the Seahawks.
Introducing the Bills with head coach Trey Walters, assistant coach Morgan Harper, Sam Smith, Hayes Holbert, Jackson Yokel, Braden Little, Abbott Browning, Jack Thomas, Rainer Braum, Travis Pankey, Porter Perry, Spencer Otto, Henry Short, and Isaac Maston. Introducing the Seahawks with head coach Kenny Budd, assistants Joseph Ames and Jake Taylor, Kaney Chambliss, Crawford Eubanks, James Booker, Jackson Kinzig, William Grubbs, James Caskey, Matthew Baxley, Billy Farrow, Caden Hoffbauer, Spear Stagner, Rushton Doster, Tate Davis, and Matting King.
Welcome back, friends. This is Josh Mandel, your play-by-play announcer today with my partner, your color expert, Josh Wright. Today you're getting Josh times two. We're really excited. It's going to be a great game today. Josh, we've got two outstanding teams that have managed to find their way to this Super Bowl. They've done it with a combination of great offense and great defense. And we want to talk about the keys to the game today. Let's start with those Bills. What can you tell us about the Bills?
You know, Josh, it's interesting. One of the things that I know we have talked offline together throughout the year, these are two of the best teams of the year. Without question, I think one is facing two in this championship, and I do agree with you. I think there are some keys to the game on both sides. Let's take the Bills first. First, we got on the Bills side. The Bills have been a tenacious defense. They have only given up five touchdowns all year. All year. When you look at that, you got three given up to the Cowboys, one given up to the Jets, and one given up to the Seahawks, the team that they're playing today. They've only given up five, so they need to be tenacious on defense.
That's astounding.
Yeah, there's no question. Just tenacious on defense and kind of play their game. I think they also have to do a good job of containing the defensive ends and their corners to try and eliminate the long, explosive runs that can come from the Seahawks from a couple of their running backs. So I think they've got to contain. The other thing they've got to do, offensively, I think the Bills have to be able to pull off successfully Their reverse play that they have implemented over the last 2 to 3 games, they've been very successful with it. They run it to Sam Smith, who's explosive out in the open field, and they run it to Jackson Yokel, who's equally explosive. I think they've got to be successful there. And then ultimately they got to spread the ball around. I think they just can't give the ball to one running back, one quarterback. They've got to be able to spread it around so you can't key on one player.
You know, it's great that you point that out, Josh. One thing we've enjoyed watching with this Bills offense is their ability to evolve as the season went on. They spiced up the playbook. They added some home run plays that we hadn't seen earlier in the season. And how they can make that work going into such a big game with such a strong defense is going to be really fun to watch. Let's go to the other side of the field. Let's talk about these Seahawks. These Seahawks have managed to make it to the Super Bowl with an almost undefeated record. They finished first in the regular season. They were the clear front runner. They breezed through the playoffs. Well, they had a tough game in the semifinals, but they pretty much did their work in the playoffs. Tell me about what we should expect from the Seahawks.
Yeah, I think there's some keys to the Seahawks. You know, you are right. They lost one of their very first games. I don't think they had really found the identity of their offense, Josh, but what they did is they have also evolved. They've evolved in a very positive way. And I think for the Seahawks there are a couple important points. Important point number one for them is they need to start fast. This is not a Bills team that you want to get down too quickly. So they need to start fast and be aggressive and start getting some yards and chipping away early and quickly. Number two, they also need to spread the ball around. If they try and give the ball to number 27, who's an explosive back, Caden Hoffbauer, and they allow the Bills to key on Hoffbauer, I think it's going to be a longer day for them. They need to be able to spread the ball around to Grubbs and some of the other players to be able to put themselves in a position where nobody's keying on one of their players. And also, I think they're going to have to find the edge. If they're able to find the edge, they're going to do what they've done all year long, which is successfully run the ball up the field. And let me say one more thing I think is important. Given the fact that the Bills have implemented and evolved into that reverse, the Seahawks have got to stuff that reverse early because they're going to run that thing 6-7 times today, and they're going to have to stuff it early on.
Absolutely, Josh. We're going to keep coming back to those key points. Here we go. We got our first play of the game. We've got the Seahawks starting with the ball on the 20-yard line. What do we got here? We've got their favorite formation, Grubbs under center. We've got Hoffbauer taking it to the left. Sheds a couple of tacklers. Brought down about 9 yards past the line of scrimmage.
You know, that takes us immediately to the first point, which is they've got to find the edge. They did a good job of finding the edge. I see Hoffbauer coming up, limping a little bit. He may have taken kind of a big hit there at the beginning. I know they'll check on him. But he does a good job once he gets that edge of getting upfield and doing it aggressively and physically.
He really is a gifted athlete, isn't he?
There's no question. He's got the speed. He's got the physicality. He's got the want and the heart, and he'll give it everything he's got. You know, and let's also thank just for a couple moments. We've got the UAB Sports Medicine folks coming out there to look over number 27, Hoffbauer. Mount Brook Athletics just would really like to thank UAB Sports Medicine for providing the certified athletic trainers for all the games this year, which has been incredible. It's a great safety aspect to the entire league. It has significantly impacted the league in a positive way. The athletic trainers this year that are certified are Samantha Davis, Lori Fincher, Wednesday Benusa, Connor Spitzer, Kaylee Cartmill, Laura Serrett, John Pellerin, Kevin Handel, and Kenneth Davis.
You know, Josh, you're right. You really can't say enough about what those trainers have done, not only for our athletes, but just for the peace of mind that we have as families on this field and knowing that we've got such great expert care right at our fingertips.
Well, and let's not overlook the fact that we've got Hoffbauer off the field. That changes the dynamic of this offense significantly. There's just no question about that.
No kidding. So we're seeing a six-man front on the Bills, and then we've got number three under center in shotgun, and it's a straight up the middle carry by.
Looks like that's William Grubbs, Josh.
William Grubbs. William Grubbs has just kind of been there. Kind of their horse, you know, just steady and a great field general for this offense. What do you think about Grubbs?
Yeah, he's done a very good job this year. They've used him in misdirection plays where he will fake a handoff and naked bootleg out, which is a great misdirection in Little League sports and football specifically. I think he's done a real good job this year. He's a physical kid both on offense and defense. And, again, he's got a tank and he'll give you everything he's got in it.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun to watch. So we're looking at first and 10, Seahawks earn a new set of downs. We have Grubbs back under center again. He's got men wide on left and right. Grubbs takes a snap, takes it around the right end. Sheds a tackler, and they're going to bring him down for what, maybe 2 yards?
Yep. You know, and I just noticed something. They did make an adjustment. They've got Crawford Eubanks, number 3, actually under center, and Grubbs at the tailback position. I think they've done that because they've got Hoffbauer on the sideline.
Oh, so that's a big change, and we'll see how this Bills defense adjusts. Let's look at this Bills defense for a moment. Any players, any formations, any movement we ought to look for. We'll come back to that in a second. We're about to take this.
I'll jump in real quick before that play gets snapped. You've got Hayes Holbert, and you've also got Porter Perry on the defensive ends, and they're playing outstanding this year. Watch those kids all game long.
Certainly. So we got Grubbs with a handoff to Eubanks, and who's that coming through?
That's big number Isaac Mastin, known as Eyes. Great hit.
We've seen him make that kind of penetration all season long. What would you say about Mastin and his impact on this defense?
You know, I think Mastin's specialty is to be able to get into holes and gaps quickly, to be able to get into the backfield and create havoc. He's done a great job this year being able to do just that. You saw it on that play. He shot the gap between the guard tackle and was right in the backfield. Very difficult to be successful when you've got a big guy like number 77 in the backfield.
So we're bringing up a third and long. Eubanks under center again, takes the shotgun snap. He tries to get around. Nothing there. Let's see who strung out. We had number 7 stringing out that play, Braden Little. We'll talk about him all throughout the day probably. We'll look for Little on both the offense and defensive side. And then we had number 44, Porter Perry, on that tackle as well.
Yeah, and it looks like what happened there is they may have had – I did not see the flag thrown, Josh, but it looks like maybe they had a replay of down because now they're showing fourth down. Let's see what they're – let's see what they're – seems to me that it should be a they've got it listed as fourth down, so they must have had a replay of downs there. But, yeah, you know, so they've had to with Caden out, big number 27, who's carried a lot of their carries this year. It looks like they put Eubanks back at the quarterback position. And then Grubbs taking some snaps, too. Grubbs is behind center,
center
now.
Grubbs is looking for – he's got we got a stoppage of play. We got a flag on the field. Probably looking at a false start.
It looks like they maybe had gone on two and he had an offside. So let's see. Yeah, that appears to be what it is. All right, yep. We've got big number 27, Caden Hoffbauer, coming back in. He looks like he's hobbling a little bit, but, again, he's going to give you everything he's got. So, he has had such a great year.
So it looks like the Seahawks must have called timeout and opted for the punt, which puts the ball on the 20-yard line for the Bills. This will be the first time we've seen this Bills offense today. And as you say, the Seahawks defense getting their number 27 back will be really important. So we'll see. The Bills come out with a quarterback under center. They have this up back on both sides. Number 7, Braden Little, takes a snap from shotgun, comes around the left end, almost tackled, makes it about 7 yards, almost a first down by a 9-yard carry. Tell us about this this Bills offensive formation and how they run it.
You know, they do a really good job. They have done a great job, as you mentioned in the intro, to spreading the ball around and to evolving as an offense. One of the most important things, I think, one of the most successful things they've done is the ability to spread that ball around. They're giving it to Abbott Browning, to Braden Little, also giving it to Sam Smith on the reverse. Watch for number 2 getting this ball in the reverse sometime soon in the first quarter. But that was a great run that last time. And when you start with a first down, it's a successful start.
Yeah, so tight formation on second and short. They take it around the left end up through the middle. And that's a long, that's about a 22-yard run. Tackle made by 27, Caden Hoffbauer. And carry made by
Looked like Abbott Browning. You know, Abbott has done such a great job this year, and he's really come on as a great running back for them. You know, his favorite subject in school, Josh, is math.
Hey.
You know what? Geometry. He's not there yet, but you know what? He's doing some geometry on the field for sure.
Hey, a man with a stem is a man with a future. All right, so we have this tight formation again on first down. Braden Little takes a snap from shotgun. Oh, there's penetration in the backfield.
I tell you what, that is where they are so good. Those defensive end positions do such a great job, Josh. That right there is number 3. We had already talked about him previously, Crawford Eubanks. He does a great job of the defensive end position.
You know, I noticed on that play as well, he had help there. James Caskey, number 4. He's 14, excuse me. He's been a lockdown corner for them this year, and we'll talk a little bit after this play about him. Bills come up again in this tight two-man up back formation. Little in shotgun again. Little takes the direct snap, comes around, and there's penetration again.
Yeah, you know, they did a real good job the first two series there, or the first two opportunities to get first downs, to get quick first downs. They had one really nice long play. They had a play that got a first down, too. They've been stuffed a little bit here. They're third and long and about the, call it the 14-yard line, given the way the field is aligned right now. I got to believe in this play you're either going to see a reverse with number two, or you're going to see a fake reverse to Braden Little, number seven, the quarterback. But let's see how they line this thing up.
So Braden takes a snap around left side. There's penetration again, but he shakes the tackler, cuts it inside, then meets a swarm of blue jerseys that bring him down after about a, let's call it a 6-yard gain. You know, that penetration is really, really strong. On the last play, we had a good tackle from Madden King, number 79, and again, Aiden Caskey, 14. What did we see right there on that play?
You know, watch, they did a fake reverse like I thought would be coming. Billy Farrow did a really good job on that right defensive end position of staying home. Although he did not initially make the tackle, he got himself back into the play. He's a super athletic, long kid with long arms. He's physical. He's not afraid to hit. And he was able to get back to the ball to make a tackle that could have been a touchdown right there. And now they face a fourth and two, which is a interesting little moment for the beginning of this game for these guys.
It is. It's a major strategy play, major strategy call by these players. Little takes. He's scrapping. It's going to be a close call. I'm not sure he got it, Josh, but it's going to be. They may have to bring the chains out for this one. There was a good surge by this offensive line, but it met a pretty solid defensive wall.
Yeah, it kind of depends where they put the spot down. It looks like it is going to be a first down. It was really close, but it looked like just got enough. And that'll kind of go back to the swag of Braden Little. He'll give you everything he has, and that was a great run right there. Sometimes you need to break it all the way. Sometimes you need 1 or 2 yards to get a first down, and that's what he's good at doing.
Yeah, you know, here they are. They come up again in this tight two-man up back formation. Little behind shotgun again. He hands it off.
There's a reverse.
And, again, a wall's met. There's penetration. Let's talk a minute about this defensive line that is coming up so strong for the Seahawks. We're seeing action by, as you mentioned, Farrow, by Madden King, by Spear Stagner.
Yeah, and we see James Booker. They've had that was a great play right there. And if you remember, one of the keys to the game that we were talking about, we'll kind of get back to some of this line play from these guys. But they needed to stuff that reverse the first couple times they run it to prevent the Bills from wanting to run it in the future. If you can't be successful on a play, you find a way to run something out. All right, and I think we're going to be off to commercial break. When we come back, we've got a scoreless end of the first quarter, getting ready to start the second quarter. 0-0 tie right here, but the Bills marching on the 4-yard line, ready to score.
All right, welcome back, everyone. We're kicking off the second quarter of this Super Bowl Sunday. When we left, the Bills were on the 15-yard line, threatening on the Seahawks. We've got this same formation. Braden Little takes a snap again from shotgun. Right up the middle. Again, he's meeting a lot of resistance. We're talking about that defensive line on the Seahawks, Josh. Who are we looking for to be a real force on this defense?
Well, Matty King, number 79, is a big body that's able to make some big tackles. He had a big one right there. It ran right into his wheelhouse. He's able to get his arms out there extended and prevent a significant gain. This is a big third down and fourth down play right here. Seahawks got to put up a stand if they're going to stay in this game in the second quarter.
Yeah, they stay committed to this formation. We're seeing some pretty good contact from the offensive line. Little takes the snap around the left end. He meets some resistance. Tries to bounce it out, and again, tell you, this blue swarm is really showing up on this defense for the Seahawks.
You know, the Seahawks defense, they call it gang green because they got enough green in there. They got a lot of bodies. They put a lot of bodies on you. That gang tackle very, very well, and that's why they go as gang green. But, you know, that defensive line for this team has been stellar this year, from Caney Chambliss to James Booker. We've also got Matthew Baxley. Tate Davis and Madden King. Let's see what they can do here on this fourth down.
So we've got Braden Little going for a big gamble on fourth down.
He's on the outside.
That speed turns up. Cuts it, and he made the first down. What a play by Braden Little. Great job. He got a great block from his up back coming around that corner, sealed the corner, and they are now looking at a first and goal situation.
Well, actually, now we got a first down. We got a touchdown there.
Touchdown.
They've aligned the and I know it's hard. You know what? It's very difficult to see how they've aligned it, but Braden actually carried it across the end zone right there. You know what we had right there was outstanding block on the defensive end. Defensive end number three there has done a great job, Crawford Eubanks, but he got sucked inside to allow Braden to get outside, and an outstanding run from Little.
So it looks like the Bills are going to go for one on this extra point. There, another great seal block, and Little is in for the extra point conversion, bringing the score now to 7-0, 6 minutes, 34 seconds to go in the second quarter, and we have our first score of the game, ladies and gentlemen.
I tell you what, Abbott Browning did an outstanding job right there on a block that he never quit on. He got himself onto number 14, who is Aiden Caskey.
Aiden Caskey.
And push Aiden Caskey out to allow Braden to cut that thing up and in for the one-point conversion.
Yeah, that's no small feat either. Caskey is a lockdown corner for this team, and it's a force that the Bills have recognized that they have to contain. So after hitting some resistance on the Seahawks defense, the Bills' offensive line and their blocking scheme really did the trick on this. We've now got the Seahawks with the ball back on their 20-yard line. They've got their horse Hoffbauer back. And Grubbs takes a snap and he pushes a few blockers. He rumbles, and he's after getting swarmed by a pack of red jerseys. He's down about a yard short of the first down.
It looked to me like either Matthew Baxley or that was Spear Stagner was in on the block there for the Seahawks to spring that run. But so far, you know, it looks like Hoffbauer's leg is holding up. He seems to be running at full speed. We'll see what this thing can do. Remember what we talked about, one of the keys of the game was having a fast start. Getting down by a touchdown is not terrible, but you got to have a sustained drive here offensively to do your job in order to stay in this game.
So we'll look for more firepower from the Seahawks offense. Grubbs takes a pistol formation snap, heads around the knees, he's tied up by two tacklers, and he's brought down by Maston. But I've got to tell you, number 12, Rainer Brom
had great Porter Perry too.
And
number
Porter
44.
Perry, really strong penetration before Grubbs ran that misdirection to the left. He was met by a lot of interruption.
Well, you got a third down here. I gotta believe that you're gonna have Hoffbauer either taking a direct snap or getting the ball to try and get this carry for the first down. We'll see.
So Hoffbauer takes a direct snap. Nope.
Looks like they put Farrow in there back at number 21, trying to get that first down, but somebody may have jumped off sides. Let's see here. Yeah, they're going to call it offsides, and that's a devastating offsides penalty. They're going to have to really step up this play call right here on third down. They need to get a first down.
You know, our coaches work on it tirelessly, but getting down these snap counts are a tremendous tactical part of this game, and it can turn a drive forward or backwards in one play.
I think you're going to see big number 21, Farrow, or number 27 with the ball in their hand right here trying to get a first down. They desperately need this first down. They don't need to go for it again. They're probably going to punt if they're not successful here. So let's see what happens.
They're showing a spread out formation with two men split out and two in the backfield. Let's see. Grubbs takes it around the left end.
He's going to get a first down.
He's got the first down. That was a major 7-yard pickup there. At this point, in the quarter, time does become a factor. We're looking at 4 minutes and 20 seconds left. Seahawks are now at midfield.
Well, you know, these games go fast. You and I talked about this before we cranked the broadcast up today. The games do go fast. They go quickly. They're halfway through that second quarter. But I tell you what, they're starting to put a sustained little drive together. Now you got Hoffbauer back in the shotgun position, solo back there.
Empty backfield, Hoffbauer. So it's a wobbler to number three, Crawford Eubanks, and he can't hold on to it. It was a tough ball to catch. Incomplete pass, bringing up second down and 10, 3 minutes and 46 seconds left. We'll see. A little uncanny to go to the pass, but sometimes it pays off.
Well, and, you know, they may be setting something up here. They may be setting a fake pass up where Hofbauer will take it around the side. I've been a little surprised because I know he was hobbling just a little bit. He looks back at full speed, and they just have not given him the ball very much. They've been spreading it around to some other backs. So we'll see what happens.
Tighter formation this time. Grubbs under center with Hofbauer in the backfield with him and two up backs to the left. Grubbs takes a snap. Another pass. Oh, my gosh. That's picked off. Picked off by another. And it's a touchdown. Picked off by the Bills number.
Hayes Holbert, number three. Big number three came in there rumbling. He's got good hands, too. I tell you what, he plays first base in baseball, also plays some basketball. He's a heck of an athlete. To step in there and intercept that pass, that was a great play.
You know, that's a tremendous play. You know, Hayes' favorite player is Cam Newton. I'm sure Cam would be real proud of him if he saw that play right now.
Well, I tell you what, I know his mom and daddy and his brother are jumping up and down, too, because that was a heck of a play. You know, just like we were talking about, maybe setting something up there. They may have been setting up the screen to the opposite side to Caden Hofbauer. Unfortunately, it was misread or improperly called there, and Hayes Holbert was able to take it to the house.
So the Bills going for one on the extra point. They try to get the outside, and as you said, Mr. Contain, as he likes to be called, Billy Farrow steps up with an important extra point stop. Josh, let's talk about these extra points for a second because they're really strategically important for these teams.
Well, you know, not only are they strategically important, they are significant to the outcome of the games. As you notice this year, we had 11 games decided by 2 points or less. And let me tell you what that tells us. That tells us that extra points, either the single extra point or the double extra point, matters. You don't have field goals yet in this grade. That doesn't happen until about seventh grade. But what you do have coaches having to make complicated decisions down near the goal line, but they have to execute on those extra points. That missed extra point could be a significant component to a win or a loss in any of these games, including this current game.
So Seahawks back with the ball on their own 10-yard line now. They have 3 minutes left to play, so a lot of time left in this quarter to make a run. Grubbs takes a snap from shotgun around the left side. Yeah, he gains about two. Again, number 44, Perry, 77, Maston. Number eight, Abbott Browning did a really strong job of stringing out the run. So
and Porter Perry, too, Josh, did a good job because what he did is even though he was not actually the tackler, he was able to string that play out. Looks like they're going to bring Hofbauer out now, they're going to bring in number four, James Booker, as his replacement. It just looks like his leg is too much. Hobbling just too much, unfortunately.
Well, we know that's a big challenge that these coaches have to make adjustments for and game plan around. You're talking about some of the disruption that's important from these defensive linemen on the Bills. You know, we've got a really strong set of linemen with Rainer Braum and Henry Short, Jack Thomas, Hayes Holbert, Isaac Mason, and Porter Perry. So we'll talk about that in a moment.
I can't say enough about Henry Short, too. If you look at big number 65 down there on the defensive line, he is trying to get in the backfield every play, doing a great job doing it.
So on a direct snap again, is that Grubbs going up the middle?
Well, I think that was Farrow, actually. They had to make that adjustment because I believe that, again, they brought Hofbauer to the sideline. He seems to be too injured to play at this point. And so Farrow with that carry. Farrow has not gotten a tremendous amount of carries, but the carries that he has had, he's had a touchdown this year. The carries he has, he's maximized. He's done a really good job. He's going to be a great running back in this league moving forward. There's no question.
So we now have a flat stoppage of play. The Seahawks have gone to their hurry-up offense. It's a two-minute warning. And they go right back to the play. Two up back on the right. Direct snap to is that Farrow?
It's Farrow once again. In on that tackle was Henry Short. And on that tackle was, number 44, Porter Perry. And also number eight, who's done a great job, Abbott Browning, who's been in a lot of plays offensively and defensively.
Yeah, Farrow kind of has a throwback favorite with Deion Sanders as his role model on the gridiron. So we're now looking at fourth down. Big gamble here. Farrow takes the ball to the left and meets a wall of red tacklers, and it's going to be closest to whether he gets that first down. He does get the first down.
Yeah, and, you know, that kind of comes back to the point I was making earlier with Braden Little on the other side, which is, you know, sometimes you need your running back to be able to spring it and take it to the house, but sometimes you got to pick up that 1 to 2 yards, and you got to be a physical back to do that. I think stepping in right here, Billy Farrow's done a great job of being a physical back, being able to get that 1 yard.
Yeah, Josh, you really can't take for granted getting a yard. It's a lot more distance than you might think. So We start again, Farrow resists Eubanks in the backfield by himself. Now Grubbs drops back. He leads a block to the left, Eubanks to the left, and he's going to have about 2 yards. And, Josh, we're looking at about a minute left on the clock that's still ticking.
Yeah, Porter Perry and Abbott Browning, really nice job right there of keeping the ball in bounds to allow the clock to run. I think they're going to be very content going in if they're able to keep it at 13-0. They're going to be very content going into halftime at 13-0.
Eubanks takes a quick snap again. He's led by Grubbs, and then the play stopped. All right, we have a timeout. Timeout called by the Seahawks.
You know, you can't say enough about these young Seahawks stepping up right here in the face of some adversity, losing their running back. But, you know, sometimes the game goes on. You got to be physical, and you got to be willing to continue to advance the ball and get first downs. They've got a daunting task here with 45 seconds to go and quite a lot of yardage to get there. But you never know in third-grade football what can happen with one play.
You're right. You never know. So maybe we'll look for some trickery, some misdirection, something to make some big home run plays here. So we've got, once again, Eubanks under center with being led by Grubbs. He takes it around. He picks up a little speed. Oh, and he's met by the lockdown corner, Aiden Caskey, again.
I think that's Yokel.
Yokel
over there, number four, has done a great job, Josh, this year of containing. And that was one of the keys to the game we talked about, is making sure that we're containing the Seahawks, forcing them in. Because, you know, when you contain and you force them in, what happens ultimately is you've got traffic and you've got a bunch of congestion to be able to stop folks.
And we got another STEM man here with Yokel. He's a science man. Favorite players, T.J. Yeldon. And Yokel scored a touchdown himself this year, and I think that's really inspired him on this field.
You know, one of the things I want to mention is Mount Brook Athletics really appreciates USA Football, which is a national organization that has partnered with MBA to certify its coaches, commissioners related to heads-up football, as we're back in play now.
And that's a pass by Farrow off to the right, about a 10-yard bomb. It was broken up by number two, Sam Smith.
Looks like they're going to punt here and try and contain with 10 seconds to go, try and cut the bleeding a little bit, go into halftime, regroup, and then make some judgment calls on what they're going to do offensively in the second half. But again, you know, I was talking about USA Football, and as you well know, we have really implemented the USA Football protocols, which have been great to keep the game a lot safer. All of our coaches, all of our commissioners are all certified. All the executive officers are all certified in concussion protocol, in protocols related to dehydration, et cetera. We really appreciate the relationship we've had with USA Football.
Yeah, great stuff. Great stuff indeed. All right, so we'll have the Bills coming out with 10 seconds left on the clock in the end of the second quarter. Little takes a snap. Little misdirection again. Hands it to the speedster, Sam Smith. Makes a cut, bounces out to the outside, and he is tackled out. He's brought out of bounds about 10 yards downfield.
Josh, tremendous block by Porter Perry there to seal that end. Looked like Crawford Eubanks may have been the one that was sealed, and sealing that end, allowing for an explosive 10, 15 yards. When you get Sam Smith in space, he can run. He is a great little running back and has done an outstanding job this year. He's had a major role in that sweep, and they don't call him Sweet Feet for nothing.
No,
he's got speed, and he can get open in space and make it happen.
So they run the fake reverse. Braden takes it to the left, meets a wall of blockers, and that's going to do it for this first half. Bills did not quit. They did not mail it in with just a few seconds left on the half.
Well, you know, the second half's going to be real interesting. We'll see where this thing goes at 13-0 at halftime. You know, one of the things I did want to say, too, Mount Brook Athletics appreciates the relationship with Capstone Collegiate Communities. It's a great group that has been a supporter of Mount Brook football. Their total portfolio includes 50 communities with over 32,000 beds and $1.3 billion in development costs. Just a great partner for Mount Brook Athletics. When we come back, we're going to talk about the keys to the second half and rolling forward.
third-grade cheerleaders for the Bills. We have Mary Hadley Adams, Mary Drew Beard, Grace Bearden, Gigi Byers, Caroline Kelly, Adeline Little, Nancy Riles Little, Mary Tanner Richards, Anna Rucker, Elizabeth Thomas, and Evie Yielding. We'd also like to recognize the third grade Seahawks cheerleaders. We have Caroline Brand, Abby Canterbury, Mary Grace Carlton, Mary Clayton Dixon, Josie Gagliano, Sarah Jane Garner, Abby Norris, and Madeline Williams. Please give a round of applause for our third grade cheerleaders.
You know, Jay Spencer, by the way, has done an outstanding job on the PA today. I just had to say that.
He has. He's brought a great voice and crisp.
Crisp delivery. I'd say crisp delivery. All right, as we're coming back here, the cheerleaders have done an outstanding job. I tell you what, it's going to be an interesting second half. You remember one of the keys to the game was the Seahawks needed to get off to a fast start and not a slow start. Unfortunately, they've got off to a slow start, but, you know, there's still a lot of time in this game. They got an opportunity to get this thing together, have some big plays, and hopefully get this thing closer.
You know, Josh, it seems that like any game of football is win and loss at the line of scrimmage.
There's no question about that. Both of these teams have an outstanding line of scrimmage, both offensively and defensively. And candidly, that's why they're the number one and the number two team. And they've played well and controlled the lines on both sides throughout the year. And it's why that they collectively, you know, have done about 15-2, 15-3 all year long. I think we're getting ready to go out to our commercial break before we get started in the second half here. One thing I did want to mention again is I wanted to really recognize the UAB Sports Medicine folks for providing the certified athletic trainers who have been involved in this game and will be over the Super Bowl games the rest of the time. When we come back, we'll start the second half.
All right, everyone, welcome back to the second half of the third-grade Mountain Brook Super Bowl between the third-grade Bills and the Seahawks. Josh, let's talk a little bit about the adjustments, the second-half adjustments that each team's going to have to make to win this Super Bowl. We'll start with the Seahawks, who are trailing in this game 14-0, 13-0. The Bills have scored with a strong offensive drive and then a big turnover pick-six by Hayes Holbert. Where's the keys for the Seahawks to get back in this game?
Well, you know, one of the things I've been most impressed with this year with the Seahawks is their coaches. They not only match on the sideline, but they work together as a unit. I have seen them out-adjust firsthand teams that have been up at halftime. and have done a great job doing it. I think they have been a little handicapped today, just a bit, based on the injury that they had to their tailback, but they've done a good job. I know they're going to do a great job coming out and trying to get a fast start. You know, the keys to the Seahawks, and you've seen it firsthand, it's the reason why the Bills have only given up 5 touchdowns all year, and this being their 10th game, have only given up 5 touchdowns. You know, it's because they play great defense, and the Seahawks are going to have to find a way to move the chains. I think they've only gotten 1 or 2 first downs in the first half. They're going to have to move these chains, and they're going to have to do it in their first drive. They can't get down by another touchdown and try and dig out of that hole. The hole gets too big at some point. I think that the Seahawks, if they will move the chains, have an opportunity slowly but surely to be successful. Well, they're going to have to play some defense right here, though.
And that's right. They're going to have to do that quickly because the Bills get the ball to start the second half, and we have to expect that this very well coached Bills team is going to make sure they do everything they can not to squander this lead and to keep their momentum going into this third quarter.
Well, and no question, you know, I've also been extremely impressed firsthand with the coaches for the Bills. They dealt with some early year adversity, and they have come through as outstanding coaches who are all in, that have done a great job as a unit getting these boys prepared and getting them to the Super Bowl with a 7-2 record. They do a great job offensively. The key to their second half, I honestly believe, is great defense wins championships. They've got to continue to use their defensive alignment the way they've been using it all year to be successful on defense. If they can reduce the number of points scored by the Seahawks in the second half, I think they're going to be okay. But that's the key to the game for them.
No doubt. One thing both these teams have in common are two terrific coaching staffs that you can just watch how the kids respond to their coaches. So
I'm expecting here in the second half you're going to see a healthy dose of Abbott Browning, a healthy dose of Sam Smith, and a healthy dose of number 8, Abbott Browning, running the ball.
So we've got Abbott, and again, Braden taking the shot. He hands off to Abbott Browning, dodges a couple of tacklers, and he's going to carry that to about the 28-yard line, close to midfield. This will bring up a second and short, and this is probably just the kind of momentum that the Bills coaching staff was hoping to establish as they got started in the third quarter.
You know, Abbott does a great job, but all that started with Big Isaac Mastin in there opening that hole up and allowing Abbott to get through, and then he exploded like you need to as a tailback when you're getting through the line.
So they come out of the huddle quickly. Braden behind the center again takes a snap from shotgun, and there's a flag on the player, probably looking at a false start.
Well, I think he's lucky that there was a false start there, because big number 79, Madden King, was about to take him a couple yards back. He had his arms and paws wrapped around him. It would have been interesting to see how that was going to end.
Well, this will bring up this will back this drive. As soon as we're talking about momentum, this will bring up a first down, actually. So Bills helped their cause with a penalty from the Seahawks. Little goes back to the shotgun. He's got Browning on his right again, takes the ball to the right, drifts out, got a good lead block from Browning, dodges the tackler, fights through a couple more tackles, and this is about a good 5-yard run for Braden. He had some help there on the right side of the ball, Josh.
Yeah, he sure did, and that is common. They have had great blocking from guys like Jackson Yokel, who sealed the end right there to allow Braden to get around the end, and then Braden did the rest with his legs. You know, Braden is a big potassium guy, eats a lot of bananas, likes
really?
Bananas. And that's why they call him the swag. They call him the swag because he can get upfield quickly, does a very good job with it. When he's got blocking, it makes it even easier for him, but he's just an outstanding back that's had such a great year.
Slippery, and now the Bills are getting deeper into the Seahawks territory. Braden takes that snap again, cuts it right up the middle. He's finding some help from some of his blockers, and he goes down for about, I think this might be a first down. Looks like he might have gotten a little help on the backside from Jack Thomas, number 11. Jack Thomas is like a little ball of power. What can we say about Jack Thomas?
Oh, goodness. Jack has had such a great year. He is 100% giving the most effort for the size kid out there. And I talked to one of his coaches indicating that Jack Thomas gives everything he's got. So what he may not have in size, he makes up for in heart and commitment and desire and drive. And that's the type of kids you want on any sport you're coaching.
We've heard him described as pound for pound the toughest kid in the league. Little takes a snap from shotgun around the left side again. There's a flag down. Looks like it could be a hold. He's dropped for about a 2-yard loss on the left side by number 21.
Yeah, looked like Henry Short there, number 65, may have gotten called for that hold. That was a close call. I'd have to see that on the instant replay, but looks like he came up a little gimpy with that arm, but he may have got himself caught holding on that play, unfortunately. That's going to back this offense up just a bit, stop the momentum, but we'll see where this drive goes.
Yeah, we see Short kind of staggering back to the huddle. It looks like he'll be okay. You know, not only is Henry a hell of a football player, but he is a tough kid as well. He is a big fan of the Green Bay Packers, and he loves the Hail Mary. That's his favorite pass.
Oh yeah, you talk to his coach, and he'll tell you that if he could call any play, he'd call the Hail Mary. I'd love to see him throwing the ball. It'd look great. You know, hey, let's talk too for a moment. Caney Chambliss, who's been in several plays, they call him Cane Break, does a great job and has been involved in several of these plays. Let's watch him the second half because he's working hard.
All right, so we see here's the reverse again. Smith takes it. He meets a little bit of disruption on the left end, and then he's hit by a sea of blue jerseys. Once again, the gangrene you referenced in the Seahawks backfield.
Well, there's a reason why this team was the number one team this year with their record, because they tackle so well. They tackle to the ball, and they don't quit. Caney Chambliss was involved in that tackle right there, playing that tackle on the defensive side. You know, that play for Sam Smith is a good one, but the left side defensive end on that case, who's Crawford Eubanks, did a very good job of blowing that play up. What you got to do with Sam is you've got to bottleneck him up inside. When he gets space, he's so quick, you can't let him get outside. And I think the Seahawks have done a good job on that play, keeping him inside and forcing traffic.
So a key third and long play here. Little takes a snap direct from right, heads around the right side, gets to about the 25-yard line of the Seahawks. And, Josh, this is going to bring up a big fourth down and five call for this Seahawks. For this Bills offense. We'll see what these coaches decide to do.
I'll tell you this. I can't say enough for Aiden Caskey on that play right there. That prevented a touchdown. That was gone. Braden Little had cut it up. He was gone. If Caskey does not make that tackle, what a great tackle from that young man, Aiden Caskey. Number 14's been buzzing all over the field today.
Yeah, those corners are major, major tools for these defenses to shut down the ends.
You know, Josh, one of the interesting things for those that understand these rules is the reason they're not kicking here on fourth and very long is because they're only going to get 6 yards out of the kick. The kick can never go deeper than the 20-yard line, so it's worth going for it here.
Absolutely. So Little takes a snap, fakes a reverse round, head cuts it up to the left, and it looks like this is a major stop by the Seahawks. On fourth down and five, the Seahawks are going to carry the ball and get the ball back on their own 25-yard, have really good field position.
Jackson Kinzig, awesome tackle right there. Great tackle. He was right in that play. He read it well and has done a great job. You know, he indicated one of the keys to his year, one of the things he learned was how to stop the reverse. And guess what? He just stopped it right there.
So as the Seahawks start their first drive of the half, close to midfield, there's 2 minutes and 44 seconds left on the clock. A tighter formation than we've seen from them before. Grubbs is behind the center in shotgun, takes a snap, fakes a handoff to Hoffbauer, heads around the left end, and he's going to get about 7 yards on the play. So a good carry to start off the second half for the Seahawks, and they're gonna have to make up some big chunks on these drives, wouldn't you say, Josh?
There's no question. Rushen Doster did a pretty good job on that play of trying to seal the end. He allowed his guy to get off the block a little bit late, but did a very good job to be able to spring the first 3 to 4 yards, and that's what they're going to need in this game.
So Seahawks go to the hurry-up offense. Eubanks takes a direct snap. Oh, and he's getting hit by a lot of penetration. That's big number 77 again.
Big number 77. You know what? If you don't block that kid, he's going to be in your backfield creating havoc. That was a great, great play. You got to do a better job of blocking him and preventing that.
So this will bring up a key third and long. The Seahawks give up most of the yards that they have from the first down run. And we'll see if the Seahawks stay in this hurry-up offense, trying to maximize the time left in this quarter. There's a minute 30 left. We're looking at a third and nine.
Well, they're going to have to get the ball to one of their playmakers to be able to try and get upfield. 11 yards, 10 yards, 9 yards in that range. Those are significant plays you've got to have. And it looks like they've got Hoffbauer in there, and they've also got Grubbs at the center. They're going to fake the reverse again. Rushen Doster does a very nice job right there of sealing that block, allowing Grubbsy to get himself upfield for a first down. Outstanding block by Rushan Doster.
Yeah, that was a huge play, and that takes a lot of moxie from a team that knows it's down. Two touchdowns, third and nine, backed up on their own side of the field, and to come up with a big play off a fake handoff like that shows a lot of grit from this young Seahawks team.
They're running to Sam Smith's side, and Sam's done a great job this year at the cornerback position stopping those type of plays, but great blocks on that last play.
So they try it up the middle. Grubbs shakes off a few tacklers before being met by about six red jerseys. We had a scrum there, Josh. Who do we see in that defensive line making some plays for the Bills?
Well, Henry Short looked like he was in that play, as was Mastin, number 77. And then number 12 also got involved in that play. Rainer Brom, who's done a good job.
Hurry up offense again. Grubbs takes the direct snap, takes it around left, and then there's that outside penetration, a little backside penetration. We have seven little, and number three, Hayes Holbert coming in for that tackle.
Yeah, Hayes Holbert has done a great job. Obviously, you saw he had the interception touchdown earlier in the game, but did a great job on being involved in that play right there and preventing the sweep. You know, speed is everything in this game, and if you're able to eliminate that by pushing backs out further, it makes it very difficult for people to get upfield.
Josh, I believe this is going to take us to the end of the third quarter. We've got one quarter left of play here, and this is going to be a big campaign for the Seahawks here.
You know, as we go into the championship quarter, the fourth quarter, can't say enough about Capstone Collegiate Communities. Again, Rob Howland, has been involved in helping support Mountain Brook football, we're so appreciative. Mountain Brook football really appreciates the role that they have played in helping sponsor this Super Bowl. Again, total portfolio includes 50 different communities with over 32,000 beds. Just a great entity. We appreciate their involvement and their support.
Probably has a lot of people in our viewing audience.
No, there's no question. There's no question about that.
All right, folks, we're back for this fourth and final quarter of the Mountain Brook third grade Super Bowl between the Seahawks and the Bills. Josh, the Seahawks are mounting somewhat of a drive here. It's been impressive. What should we look for as they continue this drive?
Well, they're obviously in two-down territory. This is a must-scoring drive. They must score on this drive without question. They've been running that fake reverse several times, but I tell you what, the Bills have done a very good job of sniffing that out and realizing that they've got to contain. They've done an outstanding job on that just continue to do their job. Hayes Holbert with a great containment tackle right there. Sam Smith got in that play, as did number 32, who was involved in the tackle itself, Travis Pankey, who's done a great job today in getting in that backfield. But, you know, this is four-down territory. I'll tell you what, this is a significant play right here because that time will wind down quickly. We're already at 7 minutes. They need a first down here, and they're going to have to successfully get inside the end zone.
Yeah, Pankey's coach mentioned that one of his favorite principles is staying home on defense, and you saw it there. He made a great defensive play. So Grubbs takes it around the left end, and that penetration from the Bills is there again on a fourth down carry.
Once again, Sam Smith, Hayes Holbert, they are totally involved in that play. Big number 12, Rainer Brom, once again being involved in the tackle too. That is a gigantic stop for them and eliminates any momentum that the Seahawks had moving forward to try and score on that play. Again, I can't say enough about the Bills' defense. Only given up five touchdowns all year and remains scoreless. The Seahawks remain scoreless in this game.
Against a very well-coached, fast, elusive Seahawks offense. So, we're here at six minutes, 15 seconds to go in the game.
The key here is hold the ball. Hold the ball, no turnovers, continue to march upfield, and do your job to stay in bounds.
Good carry to the right by the Seahawks, about a 7-yard pickup. And you talk about holding the ball, Josh. that all starts with the snap. And we've noticed really strong play out of Pankey this year, the center for the Bills. How important is that to the integrity of the play?
Yeah, so, you know, in third grade football, I would tell you, Josh, the center is probably one of the most critical components to your offense. If your center cannot snap the ball consistently, cannot do a good job of making sure that he's snapping to the right person, because there's a lot of misdirection involved and a lot of snap misdirection, they play a huge role. And then after that, they're out blocking folks, and so they're doing a great job. Pankey's done an awesome job this year.
So then the Bills kind of stutter step in the backfield. Braden carries forward, bulls his way for a first down. There is a flag in the backfield, probably a holding. We'll wait and see what the officials call.
Yeah, that's going to be a close call. I saw Henry Short, number 65, involved in that play. We'll see what they call here. Yeah, it looks like they are going to call a hold. Well, actually, they marked off 8 yards. Yeah, it's holding. You know, and I tell you what, in this league, you get an 8-yard penalty, and it's 8 yards for a first down. It makes a major, major difference and impact on your ability to keep your momentum moving forward. But again, the key to this Bills offense right now with 5 minutes to go is hold the ball, secure the ball, and do your job.
Absolutely, and this is where no quit comes into play. So Little takes hands off to Smith for that vaunted reverse play, and Smith is brought down about 3 yards short of a first down.
You know, Josh, you saw right there, as I was mentioning, the last time that Sam ran the ball, when he was forced inside by the defensive end into traffic, he was not as effective as when he was able to get out into space right there. And that's what the Bills have to do. They've got to seal that end to allow Sam's to get in space, because when you get number two in space, he's a very quick kid, can make quick moves and get upfield.
Yeah, he did a great job of keeping this drive alive and hopefully keeping his team in the driver's seat. We're going to go into a third and three play here, critical play for the Bills and the Seahawks. Snap's taken, hands off to number nine, Browning, and he pulls forward. Was that, I believe it was Tate Davis helping make the stop?
I think it was Tate Davis, and it may have also been Caskey, number 1-4. This is going to bring up an interesting call on fourth down. I think you are going to see a punt here. They're up by 2 touchdowns. You've only got 4 minutes to go. Your defense has played outstanding. I think you're going to see a punt. It looks like they're going to call either a timeout or no. It looks like they're gonna punt it.
They're going to punt it.
You know, Josh, I think that's the right call. Your defense has played as well as they have. You get about 15 yards out of that punt, force the Seahawks to have to make a big play, and they got to do it twice. And you just don't have a lot of time in this game with 4 minutes to go.
Yeah, Josh, that's a great point you make. One thing we've seen out of the Seahawks offense all year long is the home run. And it's they've taken the steam out of a lot of teams by being able to hit that home run. You hand it over to them on the 30-yard line, and all of a sudden it could be a one-touchdown game for these Bills. So the Seahawks now get the ball back on their 20-yard line. They've got 40 yards to go.
Looks like you got Hoffbauer back at quarterback for the first time since the first quarter. Let's see what happens here.
Hoffbauer takes a snap, cuts it up the middle, runs through a few tacklers before he gets about a 3-yard gain. This will bring up second and seven, and we'll probably be looking for the Seahawks squad to continue in their hurry-up offense, trying to get a quick score and tie this ball game up.
You know, the key to these defensive series right here for the Bills are going to come on Hulbert, Porter Perry, Yokel, and Sam Smith to do their jobs at the defensive end and also at the cornerback position. Forcing them inside. If you saw right there, Jackson Yokel did a very good job of sealing, forcing Grubbsy up the middle where there's traffic where the Bills can do their job, bringing up a tough third down.
Absolutely, absolutely. What should we look for? We've got a 3rd and 5. So, once again, a critical, a pivotal play here for the Seahawks offense to keep this drive going and more importantly, move the ball efficiently with this clock.
Well, you may see they've done the fake reverse several times. We'll see what we have here. I would think at some point they may actually try and run the reverse, but it looks like they've got a little miscommunication there. You may see the reverse. If not, you're going to see Farrow taking it around the end.
Farrow looks for a deep pass. He's got – oh, he had Hoffbauer open, and it was just a tough ball to bring down. Look at number 10, Spence Otto, making great coverage there at the safety position.
Spencer Otto has done a great job this year. Of playing that position. You know, one of the things that's good about him is Spencer is a very diverse kid. Not only is he involved in basketball and video games and football, he's a drawer and he's in karate, and he karate chopped that play right there and eliminated that first down.
Wow, what a true renaissance, man. As we look at a fourth down and five, at the two-minute warning, we've got a fourth down and five for the Seahawks. Let's see what they do here. They take the snap. Hoffbauer gives it to Grubbs. Oh, misdirection. Oh, it's
oh there's
interception.
Porter Perry. He's going to take that to the house.
That's a touchdown. That's bring that takes our score to 19-0. What is heads up play by Perry? Great touchdown. Great pick six.
That was a great play right there. I tell you what, they have now run two. We have talked all day about Hayes Holbert and about Porter Perry at the defensive end positions, and for Hayes Holbert to carry one to the house and Porter Perry to carry one to the house, there's only one other team that I know about that scores that many defensive touchdowns, and that's Alabama.
Yeah, it's striking resemblance between these two teams, and I know that tickles a lot of people in our viewing audience.
You know, there's a statistic they use, Josh, in college sports. The statistic is touchdowns allowed subtracting defensive touchdowns allowed to get to a net number. And if you look at the way the Bills have played, only given up five touchdowns this year, and they've now had three defensive touchdowns this year with three separate interceptions, they're down to two touchdowns allowed. Not bad.
And it probably really opens up their playbook for that offense too, doesn't it?
No question.
So one thing you couldn't help notice is not only did Perry step into the right place and make the stop, but he also made a great hands play to get that interception. And looks like the Bills carried it forward for the 1-point conversion. And did they get it?
They did not get it. I did want to mention too. There was a tackle in the end zone, about 6 yards deep in the end zone, that I think did injure Porter Perry. One of the things I would mention is these fields are very difficult. If you see it on camera, the way they have to line them up to come up with touchdowns, the way they have to use the 40-yard line on one side for the end zone, it's very difficult for these boys to understand exactly where they are on the field. I think that was probably inadvertent, but we sure hope Porter's okay. He looks like he's coming out of the trainer tent. Looks like he's doing okay.
Yeah, that's really good for us to see. So there's a... Seahawks on first down, try to carry around the right side.
Mastin and Hayes Holbert on that tackle. Short, too.
It's one thing, we're looking at a minute 36 left in this game, and one thing you have to hand it to the Seahawks for is they're not quitting. They're not mailing it in. These boys are showing up, and they're still bringing the force and the determination to stay after these Bills.
Well, I tell you what, a lot of that has to do with coaching. The coaches have to instill that mentality in these young players to continue to drive, move forward, and press, even in the face of adversity. Those things are important, and they're bigger than the game in life.
So on second down and 12, Farrow takes the ball. He starts to throw it and pulls it back, and knocked down by...
It looked like that was Jackson Yokel, but I don't think it was. Little was in on that play. He did not make that. He was not the one there, but I think it was Spencer Otto that was actually in the play, got hit in the back with the ball, and was able to knock it down with his body, and sometimes that's what it takes.
You know, it's these are key parts of the game. Spencer Otto takes his eye off that play, and maybe we're talking about a 20-7 game and some renewed energy from these Seahawks. So Billy Farrow takes a snap. He drops, looks for another pass. And it's picked off. Interception by number two, Sam Smith. Sam's looking for the carry, and he's going to score. Touchdown, Bills. That's going to take our score with 49 seconds left. It's going to take our score to 25-0.
You know, sometimes when you are pressing as hard as you possibly can press to score, that's what happens. And we saw that throughout the playoffs and throughout this year when teams were down. They're forced to put themselves in an uncomfortable position, actually have to pass the ball. When you do that in Little League football, big plays like that can happen. And Sam Smith does a great job on that interception. And not only that, but the return afterwards, there were some big blocks down the sideline to spring him for that touchdown. Josh, and I know we're up here on the extra point, but I think it probably needs to be said, the work and the commitment that you have put as our head commissioner into this league has been outstanding this year. It's been a great year, and you are to be commended. I'm honored to be able to be up here with you. to go through this stuff, and thank you for the leadership you've shown with the rest of your commissioners throughout the year, because it's been an awesome year.
Josh, you're way too kind to say. As you know, it's been a huge team effort, and you've been a key part of that team as our safety commissioner for all of our football program, and we've had six great game day team commissioners that have made this work. A lot of great parents and supporters, a lot of volunteers in this yep. program. You've been around this program for a while, and you know how it works.
Oh, there's no question, and it does take volunteers. None of these commissioners get paid for anything. These coaches don't get paid, and so it's just a community effort, and it's been great this year. It's been an awesome year.
So, Seahawks get the ball back. Again, these boys do not quit. Which is what football is all about. They take the ball. They take the snap. First down. Grubbs takes the ball. And he keeps on driving those legs. He's got about a 3 yard. And there's another turnover.
Yep. Looks like there's a turnover right there. Number three from the Bills got that ball, which is Hayes Hulbert, and he has been all over the place, as has Porter Perry on that other defensive end position. I tell you what, there are going to be some proud moms and dads tonight over on that Bills sideline. They've had a great season. The kids have played well. They've played as a unit and as a team. I know that Commissioner Charles Smith, who's been kind of in charge of that team, has done a real good job, and he's going to be super happy for this win tonight too.
Absolutely. So as the Bills line up, they're in a kill the clock formation. Little takes a snap, puts a knee on it with 36 seconds left. He's going to run this clock out, and you're absolutely right, Josh. He's supported a great coaching and volunteer effort with these Bills, and while the Bills are the winners today, the Seahawks certainly are not the losers. They have plenty of reason to keep their head held high as they head into this offseason.
Well, you know, it's been a great season, but we couldn't have done it without the UAB Sports Medicine folks. They were actively involved all season, but you know what? They were also actively involved today. There were 2-3 injuries, able to go over to those trainers and work with those trainers. They've been great to be a part of it. Obviously, the Bills are super excited for this win, jumping up and down, going nuts, and we love it. That's what Little League Sports is all about. Great win for them.
Yeah. Congratulations to our 2016 Bills Super Bowl champions. Great work by their coaching staff and their commissioner, and great work to the Seahawks. Thank you.
It's been a great pleasure, Josh. Thank you for allowing me to participate in this year, and I think we're now going to do the trophy announcement. Congratulations to the Bills and a great game played by the Seahawks.
Let's give a round of applause to the 2016 third grade Super Bowl champions, the Bills. Announcing the award ceremony. First, we'd like to award a trophy to each player of the runner-up team, the Seahawks.
All right, so first we'll do, I'm just going to start yelling out numbers.
Kaney Chambliss.
Okay, you can do it.
Yeah. Crawford Eubanks. James Booker. Jackson Kinzig, William Grubbs, James Caskey, Matthew Baxley, Billy Farrow, Caden Hoffbauer, Spear Stagner, Rushton Doster, Tate Davis, and Madden King. And now for the 2016 Super Bowl champions. Sam Smith, Hayes Hulbert, Jackson Yokel. Braden Little. Abbott Browning. Jack Thomas. Rainer Braum. Travis Pankey. Porter Perry. Henry Short. And Isaac Maston. Let's all congratulate the participants of today's game.
Number 10.
And number 10, Shane Otto.